Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining me today on the Divine Messages podcast. My name is Karina, and I am a psychic medium out of Calgary, Alberta. Today's episode is all about people-pleasing. When you think of being a people-pleaser, you may think, how can trying to be nice to others or helping them be a bad thing? But people-pleasing can go beyond simple kindness, and you may go out of your way to do things for others based on what you assume they need or want. But that may involve editing or altering your words or behaviors for the sake of the other person's reactions or feelings. And you may give up all of your time and energy just to have them like you. But in turn, you are left drained, unhappy, and borderline resentful. And when we allow other people's wants to have higher importance than our own needs, this is where we become unbalanced. For my entire life, I said yes to everyone. I never had the courage or strength to stand up for myself. I had zero boundaries, and I let everyone walk all over me. I was almost like a little puppet following along with what everyone else felt that I should be doing in my life. I now finally have somewhat of a voice, and I've learned that saying no to what doesn't feel right is the best thing that I could ever do to honor myself. I am learning that it is okay to set boundaries with others, and the only people who ever get upset by those boundaries are the ones that are overstepping them. And what I have also come to realize is that why I did these things and why I tried to people please. I now see that there is a deeper meaning behind all of it, and I wanted to shed some light on the reasoning in hopes that you can all learn to say no without guilt and that you can learn to set healthy boundaries and stand up for yourselves. So, do you feel that you are a people pleaser, or do you think that you are just being kind and helpful? Let's go through some of the signs to help you recognize if, in fact, you are one. Number one, you need others to like you. If you are a people pleaser, you spend so much of your time worrying about rejection. And so you do things just to appease them at the sacrifice of your own happiness. You have a strong desire to be needed. And if you feel that they do need you, you will be admired for your help. Number two, you have very low self-esteem. You may sometimes draw your self-worth from the approval of others. You may also feel that people only care about you when you are useful to them, and you need their praise and appreciation to feel good about yourself. Number three, you may apologize or accept fault even when you aren't in the wrong. Are you constantly saying sorry when something goes wrong? You do it because you can't stand the thought of anyone being upset or angry, even if it has nothing to do with you. Number four, you have a very difficult time saying no. You might worry that saying no to someone when they ask you for their assistance will make them think that you don't care about them. So saying yes to them may feel like the easier option, even if you don't have the time or energy to help. And some people may take advantage of your kindness, completely ignoring your boundaries because they know that you will do what they want anyways. Number five, you agree even when you don't really agree. So you might think that agreeing will win approval, and so you go along with something you don't agree with just to keep everyone happy. But in turn, you are just setting yourself up for frustration later on. Number six, you are a giver. You may love giving to others, but secretly you are doing so with the goal of being liked. You give and you give and you give, all with the hopes to receive their love and approval. And you are often left feeling used when it isn't reciprocated. Number seven, you have very little free time. Notice how much spare time you have to do something for yourself. Are you too busy being the caregiver to your family and friends? Are you always everyone's punching bag? Do you spend your free time worrying about everyone else but yourself? Those are true signs of a people pleaser. Number eight, arguments or conflicts truly upset you. If your goal is to keep everyone happy because you are a people pleaser, then their anger or not being happy means that you have failed at pleasing them, so you will go out of your way to do whatever it takes to keep the peace. Even if the conflict doesn't involve you, you still try to be a peacemaker because you have a very difficult time being a witness to it. Now, being a people pleaser isn't all that bad. It shows that you are a kind, compassionate, and empathetic person. But trying to win others over can mean that you are neglecting your own needs. You are doing things because you feel that this is the way to get their approval. You may be doing things that you really don't want to do because you are afraid that they won't like you if you don't. So you may even pretend that you are happy to help, but that isn't exactly the truth. And over time, this can hurt you and your future relationships if you don't learn to say no without guilt or fear of disapproval. In the long run, you may end up resentful and frustrated that you have spent so much time doing things for others that they may or may not recognize, and they may not even appreciate your efforts. And over time, they may end up taking advantage of you, even if they don't intend to, all because you always said yes. And if you continue to people please, eventually you will find yourself in relationships with friends, co-workers, or even romantic partners that don't satisfy you anymore. A good and healthy, strong relationship is well balanced between giving and receiving. When all you do is give to present yourself as the person you think others want you to be, you aren't being your authentic self. One major impact of being a people pleaser is stress. This can happen very easily when you say yes and take on more than you can handle for the sake of others. You may end up not having enough time to do all of the things that you need to get done in your life because you are so busy spending all of your time making sure that others are getting what they need accomplished. And then you end up burning out because you have zero energy left for yourself. So why exactly do we do this? What happened in our lives that allowed us to put everyone else first? Why do we need to seek the approval from others? Well, they tend to develop from a combination of many things, such as past traumas, self-esteem issues, and fear of rejection. If you have ever experienced trauma as a child or as an adult, you may not have felt safe and felt you weren't able to have boundaries with others. And you may have learned that it was safer and easier to do what other people wanted by taking care of their needs first. As far as self-esteem goes, if you learn that your value comes from what you can do for others, this is a pattern that will continue on unless addressed. And if you struggle with fear of rejection, you tend to avoid conflict at all costs and always end up doing what everyone else would like because you never want them to be upset with you or not like you. But these behaviors can be overcome with a conscious effort to break the patterns of people-pleasing. The first thing that you can do is to practice putting yourself first. It is not selfish, it is self-care. It is wonderful to be a kind, helpful, and caring person, but you cannot give from an empty bucket. So learn to fill up your bucket full of self-care before you offer your help to others. The second thing is to make sure that your acts of kindness are not coming from a place of earning approval from someone else. Before offering help, really ask yourself how you think you will feel after. Will it bring you joy to be of service even if nothing will be offered in return? The third thing is to learn to set healthy boundaries. This step is one of the most important things that you can do to overcome people-pleasing. It is perfectly okay to say no to others. And before you consider offering any help, really try to consider these three things. Number one, how will you feel by doing it? Is it something that you really want to do, or are you dreading it? Number two, do you have time to attend to your needs first? Will you have to sacrifice your limited time, or will you be skipping out on one of your needs or chores? Number three, how will helping someone make you feel? Will you be happy to do it, or will you resent the fact that you are doing it out of obligation? And I will admit, I still sometimes struggle with saying no when people ask me for something. But I'm starting to be better at knowing when to say no when it has nothing to do with spiritual help. So, for example, if friends ask me to go out somewhere, if I don't have the energy because I'm so burnt out from work, I will let them know that. And I'm slowly working on setting more boundaries when it comes to spiritual guidance. As I've said before, I have so many people message me from morning until night asking me for help and insight. And I really do love helping. I'm just trying to get better by telling them that I'll look into things when I actually have the energy or spare moment to do so. I'm really getting much better at recognizing when I'm running on empty and cannot provide them with the answers in that moment. And I do understand that part of my life purpose is to be of service to others. I just need to always make sure that my tank is full so that I have extra to give out. This year has been a really important year of reflection for me. I have started to take more time to relax, time for self-care, and I've noticed that I haven't felt as stressed or burnt out like I used to be. So I want to leave you all with this today. We are all a work in progress. It is not always easy to break a long-standing pattern, but as long as we work towards self-improvement, that is all that matters. It's important to remember to set some healthy boundaries and only give to others from a place of love. We do not need the approval from anyone else, and it is perfectly okay to say no, because when we do that, we are honoring ourselves. We will be much more willing to give our time and energy when we are doing things for others with a full tank. That way they aren't being done out of some sort of obligation. Self-care is not selfish, it is crucial. The more that we take care of ourselves, the more we have to give. So I want to thank you all so much for joining me today on the Divine Messages podcast, and I really do hope that you all can go forward in your lives and recognize whether you are a people pleaser, and if you're burning out, to take care of yourselves. Please bear in mind that the perspectives and opinions represented in this podcast are based solely on the Divine Messages interpretations. We can in no way be held responsible for the actions of our followers.